Welcome, enlightened viewers, to Science and Spirituality. This week, our guest is Macedonian psionic or psychic researcher Pane Andov. Throughout his life, Mr. Andov, a vegetarian, has had numerous extraordinary encounters with extraterrestrials and unidentified flying objects, or UFOs, which he has shared with us in previous programs. Crop circles are wonderfully arranged, impressive geometric forms that mysteriously appear in farmers' fields overnight. Many believe these magnificent creations are messages from otherworldly beings. In this two-part series, Mr. Andov will shed light on the meaning of various crop circle designs and discuss the enormous changes he says our planet and humanity will experience at the end of 2012 and beyond.
I would like to share our amazing information, what is going to happen in the near future about 2012 and 2013 event. I would like to offer people the information that was passed to me by the extraterrestrials that are willing to help. If you get the latest update from the Fermi Gamma Ray Space Telescope, a cosmic jet was actually recorded in the Milky Way galaxy, which is 25,000 light years in every direction from the galactic plane. So in crop circles like this, you see a source of energy that is spreading towards the edges, then this energy is extremely fast, it's massive, and it's coming, and it's almost at near us. This is the depiction of the Milky Way galaxy, and when it comes, it's going to hit the sun and produce something that is called a red giant phase. This wave of energy is a few million degrees Celsius and is highly magnetic. And the surface of the sun is only 6,000 degrees Celsius. If something that is millions of degrees Celsius touches a surface of a plasma that is only 6,000 degrees Celsius, it would be enough of the star to spend all its fuel and to move from its main sequence into what is known as red giant phase, like in this crop circle.
The Sun radiates heat by converting hydrogen within its core into helium in a process known as nuclear fusion. The Sun's characteristics are just right for enabling life on Earth to flourish and be sustained. Once the hydrogen at the Sun's core becomes depleted, a process that normally takes 5 billion years, the core begins to contract. The star then collapses and releases gravitational energy into its surrounding outer layer, causing it to expand and transforming it into a red giant. When the red giant phase ends, the Sun will become a smaller, cooler star which is known as a white dwarf. Mr. Andov has determined from analyzing the crop circles that after the energy wave arrives, the Sun's white dwarf phase will be reached within months.
This is the close-up of the crop circle that was delivered and the red giant phase. This is, in my perspective, one of the most important crop circles that were delivered. It appeared on July 15, 2008 on Avery Minor in the United Kingdom. It's the depiction of our solar system with all the planets and with only slight deviation. Pluto is not the same.
As it is possible to calculate the position of all the planets in the solar system on a specific future date, the alignments of the planets in the UK crop circle match what their position should be on December the 23rd, 2012.
There was another depiction, another warning, which actually took place on 29th of March 2011, when we experienced this amazing display above the sky of New Zealand. When people started to analyze those stars, they were matching exactly the same, December 23rd, 2012. This crop circle, the dragonfly, is symbolizing the extreme changes, and the phoenix, which is extremely important, is a mythological bird that lives a very life, very long lifespan. And when it recognized that its life is coming to an end, it puts a fire into the nest, and it burns to ashes. So from those ashes, a new small phoenix is reborn. That's a symbol that the sun is going to be reborn soon. So it's all a symbolic depiction. So red giant phase, is it scientifically possible?
What are the consequences for the planets when the sun becomes a red giant?
It's going to do a slow expansion which will begin on December 23, 2012, and it will culminate on 28th of March 2013. The Sun here is expanded, and it had swallowed Mercury and Venus completely. That leaves Earth and Mars very, very dangerously close to the Sun.
The energy emanating from the center of the galaxy will not just transform the Sun. Pane Andov says it will make contact with the rest of the solar system as well.
This energy, as it's spreading towards the edges of the galaxy, it will also pass through all the planets, including Earth. So just for comparison, the hottest layer of our atmosphere is thermosphere. It's around 1,500 degrees Celsius. Most of the time it's less than 1,500 degrees Celsius. So what happens when a cloud, which is highly, highly magnetic and millions of degrees Celsius hot, touches with the atmosphere of a planet which is only, let's say, 1,500 degrees Celsius hot? It's just going to deplete the whole atmosphere. So there are plenty of changes on the 3D level that we need to be aware of.
Mr. Andov has learned that our Sun has a companion or twin star located on the outer edge of the solar system. The Sun becoming a white dwarf will enormously change the relationship between these two stars.
I will just need to mention this. The other celestial object spotted on the skies is actually a twin star orbiting around our star. And this energy that is approaching will hit that star also. And when it's going to hit, that star is going to move towards the white dwarf. What we have seen in the astronomy, two white dwarfs are attracted by each other gravitationally. They start to rotate around each other, eventually they collide. And when those two will collide, they will produce a bigger star, which to produce enough light and heat that will provide the conditions for life again. So what I'm trying to say with this is that this white dwarf alone is not capable of producing the same amount of light as we are receiving today, which means it's not capable to produce the same amount of heat that we need to survive on the surface.
Mr. Andov believes that the energy wave heading towards Earth need not lead to disaster. Rather, we can take steps now to protect our planet.
But this energy that is approaching can be shielded. And the crop circles are leading us towards the conclusion and to the answer how we can do this. The data that arrived through the crop circles, plenty of information was about the fractal geometry. And people realized that they are referring to fractals. But in reality, they are referring that this universe we live in is a fractal universe. And we can influence it.
Pane Andov says that although the recognition of fractals is correct, most don't understand that the data is saying that we live in a fractal universe and we can influence or change the universe.
If you recall the research of Dr. Amoto about the water molecules, the humans are able to change the crystalline structure, turn into something magnificent. We have the ability to influence one of the elements, water. But that's not where it stops. We have the ability to influence the fractal momentum or structure of the rest of the elements that are present on Earth. So that's the first momentum that we need to understand, that we have the capability, the power in us that is dormant, that if united, it can produce a change to the matrix. So how can we do that? By combining energy. And the only known tool to me is meditation. Massive group global meditation, where millions of people can unite into one meditative oneness, and they can impact the fundamental structure of Earth.
In addition to meditation, like Pane Andov, many across the globe are calling on humanity to immediately end our destructive habits, including the slaughter of our fellow beings for food, so that we can preserve our world for future generations.
People need to change. First thing is they need to realize that this world is a world that we're sharing with other species, and we have no right to kill anything. The first momentum is that people become vegetarians, because every time when they consume meat or fish, there is something definitely wrong going on. I will explain in this fashion. Let's say if a patient that goes to heart transplantation, before that he or she was not skilled into playing piano, violin or some other musical instrument. And after that heart transplantation and the patient had recovered, that same patient start to express fundamental skills and ability to play piano or violin, which was impossible in the past. What took place? It's simply like in computers. You put new hardware in, and if you have the necessary drivers, the processor will recognize the new hardware and it will make it functional. In this same particular case, that previous host that was hosting that heart was extremely skilled in playing violin or piano, and that same knowledge was passed to the new owner. The brain had decoded through the DNA. So imagine when people consume meat. That animal, before it was killed, had suffered a trauma, a stress, a terror, which was condensated into the structure. And when we consume that stuff into our bodies, we actually inherit the same emotion, the same energies, and it produces a DNA virus. And this DNA virus further goes to diseases and completely lowers the vibration. So it's lowering our vibrational field. And without a proper vibrational field, we cannot tune into this meditative oneness that we are talking about. And what is more, even important, that we don't need to kill animals or fish, because we are light beings and we can exist on vegetables, even on prana, if some people go towards that path.
Thank you, Pane Andov, for sharing with us the valuable knowledge you have gathered from extraterrestrial sources regarding our universe. Your message of hope, which asks humanity to quickly embrace vegetarianism and practice group meditation to safeguard our wonderful planetary home, is a beautiful one. For more details on Mr. Andov, please visit www.paneandov.com. DVDs and ebooks by Mr. Andov are available on the same website. Please join us again next Monday on Science and Spirituality as we continue our interview with Pane Andov about Earth's future and the workings of the cosmos. Thank you, perceptive viewers, for your company today on Science and Spirituality. Words of Wisdom is coming up next after Noteworthy News. May we forever treasure the world in which we live.
For more details, please visit www.SupremeMasterTV.com/SS.